didn't realize that my camera wasn't working again. Anyway, where is it? Where is it? There it is. This is what we're playing today, at least for a moment. I'm drinking coffee right now, and I don't feel like stressing over Red Dead. I'm just kidding, it's not stressful. It's just what this is what I feel like playing. I don't remember what the fuck I was doing in this. But, apparently we're doing pretty good, so. Is there a place I could put my cam in here that won't be intrusive? No. No, there isn't. Oh well, I don't care. I could probably put it in the upper right hand corner, maybe. Let me try. I guess that's better. Well, so far I got a B minus for my performance. Apparently they don't care how well I did in the Munster Cup, but that's fine. I am. Apparently they're very pleased with how far I've gotten in the Senior Challenge Cup. And we're about to take on Waterford, who's in the Premier Division. And they're number 4 in the Premier Division. What formation do they like to use? 4-4-2. That's not the one I have problems with. I think it's the 4-2-3-1 that I have issues with. Let me check here. Nope, they're 4-4-2. And I also lost against Longford, who is a 4-2-3-1. And I've lost against these dudes 4-4-2. Already looked at them. Shit. These guys. 4-4-1-1. These guys. 4-4-2. I just. Apparently, it's my kryptonite. Who do I win against? I don't think I ever looked at that. Well, actually, okay, we're not that bad against the 4-4-1-1. So let's look at these guys. Oh, they're actually in the Premier Division too, and we fucking spanked them. What formation? Yeah. So, huh. Apparently he's injured. We'll go ahead and put O'Driscoll on for him. All right, fuck it. Let's try it. Shit. Oh, shit. I don't know how we're gonna. I remember when I was playing this last time, I was like super confident, but now that I know we're going against a formation that consistently gives me issues, I don't know. Don't know how to feel about it. Faces the impossible. Wait, isn't that what they said? Hold on here. August 31st. Yeah, they said that we were gonna lose against them too, so. We'll just have to see. Not feeling very confident here. All right, let's do it. Probably gonna get tore up, but we'll see. All right. Have to put my football manager hat on here. That was a good cross. Be actually more worried if we got out to like a one goal lead. What they might do. Good save. Free kicks are pretty much the only things that screw us. Don't you card him for that. Thank you. Very good save. If we win this, we're probably going to win this cup too. This is probably going to be the toughest team we'll face in the whole thing. Because I'm pretty sure all the other teams are first division. We've been playing Premier League teams this whole time. And we're in the quarterfinal. So, well, we actually have people up front now. That's been the problem. Our transition's been awful. We don't have anybody up front, which is weird because I'm playing a 4-2-4. You'd think that there'd be people up there, but they're really having trouble getting the ball forward. Hunt is the best goalkeeper in, like, all of Ireland, at the very least. Like, if I had to pick between having, like, Hunt on my team for 10 years and Turner on my team for 10 years, I'd probably, honestly, I'd tell Turner to pack his bags. They can't win if they can't score. It's always these things that do this to us. And we'll watch. We'll score a goal. And then they'll score a clean goal. What are my They don't seem to be trying to tackle. Or better yet, we'll get a goal and then I'll have a red card on my team. I'm not switching to attacking yet. I don't think it's necessary. We're getting a lot of good chances up front when we do get up there with the majority of the players. Everybody on my team's getting yellow cards now. It's great. I only have 3 subs I can make. It's almost like they're playing counter or something. Come on.
Alright, we're gonna switch to attacking. The game like freaked out for some reason. Such a joke, man. Well, that kind of fucks me because I wanted to sub in somebody else, but now I have to sub in a defensive back, very least. Henry's doing the worst, so he can come back here. Really can stay in the middle. I'm gonna go ahead and have these guys run inverted, I think. And attack. See what happens. He's just carding literally carding my whole team. Holy shit. Was a season game instead of a cup fixture, because you know, it'd be like, whatever. We obviously could have won this game. But there's not another day when in cup play, there's just you win or you lose. And the fact that they've only gotten one goal so far shows that we're by far the better team. And it was off a penalty kick. We're easily better than this team. I don't know why I was so nervous. Other than the fact that I knew this would happen. But whatever. Well, let's see. I think I'll go ahead and bring in Porter, maybe, for Murphy. And then bring Porter down. To here. And have him attack. And we'll bring Leonard to the middle. I'll actually switch him with this guy. Attack. And then you'll be box to box. You're still gonna tackle harder than that tight end center. And you're actually gonna go inside forward. Or no, wait. No. I had it right the first time. Actually move him slightly off to the right. Or you know what? No. I'll put him in the middle. Put a hit out on this ref. Wish that was possible. Well, you know what? We're just gonna switch to a 3-2-3. I don't have any more defensive guys that I can put in, so fuck. I've never had my whole fucking team get carded like this before. Ever. Like, this is just unheard of. Roberts might be good here. Oh, Porter's injured now. That's great. I'll put him here so he doesn't have to, run so far. Keep him there. And I guess I'll take Fox out and replace him with O'Driscoll. And I'm just gonna do some weird ass shit where I like do this and do that. Can he go on the other side too? Yes, he can. So this is what we're gonna do. This is Football Manager.
If we would have scored a goal on them, I would have bought everybody beer. I probably still will.
Like, this team is garbage. Like, I can't wait to get into the Premier League. Just to shit on them. They couldn't score a clean goal on me until after I had two players red carded. And we've actually threatened to score like twice on them now since then. To do at this point. It's pretty much the equivalent of fucking your cadaver right now. Just because it's not alive. And I'm sure they get the same sick satisfaction from it too. So that's basically what my team's been reduced to. I'm sure they figure as long as it's warming gel, it'll be just fine. That's what they're thinking. Yeah. I just want this game to be over. Where's the, oh, it's right here. Get on with it. First, yeah, I'm not gonna. I can't fault any of them. Yeah, you know what? I do. I really think it was bullshit. That ref fucked them. My assistant decided to fuck up the whole pep talk, I guess. Whatever.
So what's the rest of our schedule look like? We only got four more games left this year. I would like to go out, I think, with four more wins. That would put us positive for the year. Well, then I have some suspended dudes down here. No, maybe. I don't remember. Really sucks having two defensive centers, rather, suspended. So I have to pretty much just put in whoever. And I'll put in I guess Fleming. I would like to have a press conference about that. Like to speak my mind.
We're going to dump some news on the racing community that will send shockwaves across NASCAR. Tony Stewart has fired his unfiltered opinions on none other than Joe Gibbs and Richard Childress in a surprising turn of events. Their shady activities have been exposed. and Stewart holds nothing back in revealing the grim reality behind their driver picks. So buckle up, because you won't believe what he's about to say. But before that, please subscribe to our channel and hit the like button and an unyielding passion for the sport. Unfortunately, over the years, NASCAR has witnessed a troubling trend: favoritism that taints the selection of drivers. Behind the scenes, some teams have resorted to a practice known as hiring paid drivers. These individuals essentially purchase their way onto the track, bypassing the rigorous journey that genuine talents undertake. While having sponsors backing a driver isn't inherently wrong, it does cast a shadow over the deserving drivers who have poured their heart and soul into earning their spots. It's disheartening to acknowledge that such selections have become a part of NASCAR's fabric. However, amidst this dark cloud, there shines a beacon of integrity: Stewart Haas Racing. Recently, the racing community eagerly awaited an announcement from Stewart Haas.
Okay, this doesn't tell me anything. I hate when video titles and thumbnails are completely misleading. It's annoying.
I don't have a lot to say right now. Almost want to save scum that game, but I'm not going to. One game is a lot to sit through, and, you know, I already know that my team is better, so it doesn't matter. And we did win one cup. That's good. That's actually way better than I thought we were going to do. We beat Cork City, who is currently placing higher than Waterford is in the Premier League, so fuck 'em. Yeah, I think I can actually stay with this formation. I've been debating about changing it for a while, but I think with this, it's just better. The players seem to like it, so. I wish there was, like, one feature they really should add into this is, general manager mode or owner mode or, kind of, like, let you pick any single one job on the team and play from that and then, like, maybe get hired into other things. In my opinion, some of the newer features they've added into the game since 2020 has just been kind of mediocre. And now they want $60 for the game. It's like, I don't know about that guy.
And they got beat by who's this? Oh, another Premier team. Oh, shit. I could have beat that team. I really don't want to be their manager anymore. I thought I quit that team. Whatever. I guess I'll stay on it for now. What is this? Is this a qualifier? Yeah. Okay. Shit. I guess I'll stay on it. So what's my strategy with this team? I think I changed it forever ago. I never changed it. Yep. It's some retarded ass formation that I made. Hold on, let me go to my current team. And I'm gonna save this. Can I not, like, select anybody for my shit right now? I don't get it. I guess I'm just not going to have a team if I can't select anyone. Whatever. If anyone needs to go on a coaching trip, it's me. I'm not asking for anybody else. I don't understand how they're the favorites, but I don't know, whatever. The media is retarded anyway. Probably gonna be my last game. I am interested to see how the fuck I'm gonna play Vietnam without any players on my team. You need to go out there? Wait, what's the competition rules here? I don't think there are any regarding that. Well, we're going against the Dread 442. Let's see how we do. Oh, wait a minute. That was a little unnecessary. Yeah, switching from balance to positive completely changed this team. Like, once I switch to positive, I no longer think I need to try a different formation. Like, we're actually doing really good against the 4-4-2 ever since I switched to it. Close. See, the one thing that I don't like about this formation is, like, once we get it into their final third and we have everybody forward, we're almost guaranteed a shot on the goal. Almost guaranteed. But the problem is, once we lose that possession after that shot, it's like we don't get the ball again for a while. Like, a quality time with the ball. You know, like, we kick it forward a lot, like he's doing, but we don't ever get under the ball. Yeah, he just kicked it right to the other team. But I know that's pretty much part of this formation, is to kind of like get the ball forward and then have everybody just go forward and crash the box and just fucking make random ass shots. And that's great, but I don't know. Hunt is such a good goalkeeper. I don't hold anything against them from that last game. It was all bullshit. It was pretty much rigged. we're not really getting any position right now. That should have been a yellow. That was like blatant impedance. Impedance? Impeding? Forward progress? I thought refs took that shit like extra seriously compared to just some random foul. Like he literally stopped the break from that foul. I haven't seen the refs play on advantage here in this season. I don't think. Where they like have a foul, but they keep the game going until there's a stoppage in play. This has actually been a really boring game to watch. Well, we've had 50% possession, but only 4 shots. It's not good. I haven't been doing my shouts either. Could be why. So hard to get the ball in the box. Like usually we at least have the midfielders open to where they can get the ball from the winger and take like a shot or something, but that hasn't really happened either. Thank you. Horford too, who's just cancer against me. It's my kryptonite. Apparently Connor's doing the worst. So we'll just switch him out. And we'll go ahead and switch to, you know what? That's it. I'm not gonna switch to attacking you. That was a good ball one. That was a terrible ball on. He didn't have anybody. Like, I have a poacher and two midfielders that are supposed to go with the ball. He had nobody to pass it to. That. Hunt did so well, too. I gotta make another sub. Put Fleming in. Yeah, they're playing counter. Good to see him. And Turner's playing like shit today. It's not like him at all. Why did he pass it? I'm so confused. That was a clear shot. Oh. Well, my phone's on silent, so I didn't get that.
Why did he pass it? Oh my goodness. Do I have to tell my midfielders to shoot more often? I need to make another sub. My team doesn't want to shoot the fucking ball. You know what? No, we'll keep him on this. I am gonna have him attack though. Gonna switch these guys out. Really hard to do anything when we don't have the ball, like, ever.
I'm gonna go ahead and make him inverted. No, that didn't do anything. That's unacceptable. With that formation, we should have way more shots. I mean, I already have shoot on sight on, so, like, they should be shooting more often.
One thing I would like to do is adjust this, because we just, pretty much every time we get a corner, we just lose possession. So, I think what I'm gonna do is bring them back. And have them lurk. Actually, I'll have them lurk. Yeah, that's better, I think. But even still, he is going to... So I have him doing short right now. You know, maybe I should just do this. Yeah.
Bacon meat. Yeah, I'll be baby.
I do need somebody attacking from the outside, though. That I definitely do need. So, yeah, I think that's the problem. I never changed his instructions. So, this is fine. I'm going to have him attack the ball from the edge. He's going to go forward. These guys are going to lurk near the post. I'll just let him do mixed. I trust his judgment. Free kicks. Attack. We need these to be pretty much the same, I think. I don't need anybody standing with them. I think that's stupid. That's pretty much the same. Oh, wait a minute. Mixed. There we go. And indirect deep. Okay, I like that. How about throw-ins? That's another thing that we should probably work on. I don't think we should have anyone short. And we shouldn't have anyone staying back either. It should always be this guy. And that should, okay, that's correct. Looks good to me, I think. And penalties. Well, that's self-explanatory. Yeah, both of these guys are gonna have to get replaced. They've been playing like shit. Yeah, I'll do that for now. My main defenders are healthy again. And Porter will probably be fine. So I'll put him in for... I guess Fox, because Fox is just playing like dog ass right now. Okay. That should help things a little bit.
Anyway, I'm gonna go make some food. I'll be back on later, probably with Red Dead or Metal Gear or something. So, toodles. I'm on the wrong fucking...